What's up, y'all? It's Tamaj tonight. It's time for another one. So, Cowboy Bebop Netflix edition. I wasn't going to talk about this game, but something came up that I had to talk about because it's just like, really? Y'all going to go there? Y'all going there, right? You're going there. So, let's get this straight. Now, I talked about Ed. So, Ed, even though Ed is a girl, she is a girl. There's no fluidity about that. She's just a tomboy, right? Faye was just Faye. She was an older woman who was in cryogenesis. Really didn't have anything to do with any LGBT thing, but in the show, she's lesbian. And Gren, who is a war criminal, who's on basically a prison planet, per se, and he was just given drugs that gave him boobs for the most part. Now, in the anime, which honestly was very progressive for its time, let's be 100%. Nobody had a problem with that. It's regarded as one of the top animes of all time, right? Cowboy Bebop, that is. And it was very progressive for its time. So when they had that situation where you have Gren, and he's, you know, Faye is attracted to him because he looks more manly than anything else, right? And only when she finds out that he grew boobs that she's really like, oh, something's a little off there. Now, he does say, in his current condition, which could be a side effect of the drugs he was taking, he doesn't really prefer men or women. So, essentially, he's more, if he wanted to be anything, he's asexual, right? I guess you would say that. Fast forward to now. Now, again, I said in the show, Faye is now lesbian. Ed is non-binary when she should be just a tomboy. And Faye should be straight. And if you're going to say anything about Gren would have just been considered asexual. It's neither men or women. But he did look more like a man. What gets me is this whole thing we have people who are doing stuff. Now, I don't think they sold the rights totally to Netflix. It just gave them the rights to do an adaptation. But it's like, just think of it like this here. Say you decorated your house. You decorated your house. And then you rented it out. You rented it out. Now, renting it out would be, yeah, you know what? Let's say renting. Let's say you rented out the house. Right? And now, most landlords will say, hey, you can do whatever, just make sure it is, basically, you can't alter, like, you can't knock down walls, or you can't really do, you can paint, but it has to be, you know, painted back the way it was, essentially, once you're done, which could be a consideration of being an adaptation, where you can paint, you can kind of give a little bit what you're doing, but the walls, the structure's all the same, you can do that. That's like somebody coming in and says, you know, I want to knock down some walls, bang, 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 boom, boom, and paint, and then say, hey, by the way, we fixed that for you. But that's not what you were supposed to do. You can do some slight altercations like painting, which is fine, and then just move on from there, right? That's what this is like. And what am I talking about? Boom, this is from Men's Health. It says, Cowboy Bebop star Mason Alexander says the show is righting the wrongs of the anime. Again, back to what I was saying. Very progressive anime for its time. You don't go into somebody's house, even if you're renting it. And that's why I can kind of use the analogy for the using the rights for it. So you're renting it, essentially. You don't go knock down walls. You can paint, but the wall stays the same. That's how I feel about this. So in this, they, of course, people can't act anymore. They have to be the thing that they are acting. So the person that's playing Gren is non-binary in real life. Which again, Gren is not non-binary in the anime. And if you look at the way the setup for this character is, he is leaning more towards female, but saying they're non-binary. That again, knocking down walls. The point of the matter is, he was on a planet who was nothing but men. So if he was basically, which for Faye, it was a little situation too, I believe. I'm a little fuzzy on that because she was on that planet too. you know, looking for bounty. And which plays a good part in the fact that he still, you know, was like a man normally in his like day-to-day life. But when he goes to take on Vicious, he does just like a woman. Then that's when he does that. Because it was a ploy to get close to Vicious to, you know, try to assassinate him. So when you have a situation where, essentially, you know, it's all about the LGBTQ in here. I'm not going to go over this whole thing. You can go check it out if you want. But the thing that really got me, where is it at? Oh, yeah, right here. Here it is. Boom. It says, so a lot of fans think they understand the nuance of that and are very excited to talk about LGBT. And there are obviously a lot of people who are not queer, who are not trans, who have a lot of experience with kind of identity and arguing semantics of a thing. They sort of be like, well, Grin is this and Grin is that. Grin can't be non-binary. Grin is not trans. All is what I was just saying. So the thing that stood out to me a lot, especially when you have these conversations, it's always about people not understanding gender, right? So here's the deal. There's science behind, you know, genders. All right. We're not going to go through all that because we know what the science is. Now, what you can have a discussion about, and I made this point, you can have a discussion about gender norms as far as like conformity. You know, if that you could say that might be a social construct. You can say that, I guess. Right. You can make that argument. But the scientific version of things, you really can't change that. Now, I know people who have that situation where they feel in the wrong body. Okay, cool, whatever. That is what it is. But when it comes to Grin is not that situation. Grin was given, again, it was the drugs that did this to him. So it wasn't even like he was in a situation where he was feeling that way and that was something he chose to do. This is something that was done to him. Which to me seems a little, again, I would see why you would change that in the aspect of, you know, especially if you're telling your story, again, not acting if you're telling your story. But overall, I'll say this. If it ain't broken, don't fix it. And you can't go into somebody's house and start fixing their stuff when you're renting and say you fixed it when that's not what you're supposed to be doing. Bottom line. And I think this is one of the main reasons why this thing is not going over well. I have no intention on watching this thing because, like I said, if you're going to watch it, which, by the way, actually says that in this, is if anything, is to bring people more to the anime. Yeah, you think? I would like to think that would bring people more to the anime. They should go to the anime first rather than watch this because watching this first, from what I understand, this ain't it. This ain't it, Chief. It is not it. So, with that being said, like I said, y'all really need to stop trying to fix things that ain't broken. You really, really need to stop doing that because it ain't working for you. It ain't working. I can tell you right now it ain't working. But anyway, let me know how you feel about that. Like, share, subscribe, and of course, hit the notification bell so you can get my videos when I drop it. Remember, you can't be good, be good at it. Satisfied with that.